สวัสดีครับ Good morning. Today is Saturday, the 14th of June, 2019. Let me recall a bit that last week I was talking about the illiberal democracy like an atmosphere, an umbrella spreading over the Thai parliament and the Kingdom of Thailand as a whole. In the sense that in the parliament as of today, there are basically two groups. One the government side, the other is the opposition. On the government side is a coalition government led by the current Prime Minister of Thailand, General Prayut Chan-o-cha, who was the leader of the coup d'etat that took over the helms of government 5 years ago, and was able to have a constitution that allows the continuation of the military in Thai political life. So on one hand, we can say that on the government side is a military-led coalition government. On the other side, the opposition, comprising several political parties, but all of them still have the allegiance towards the former Prime Minister of Thailand, Khun Thaksin Shinawat, who is on a political exile in combination of running from the criminal justice of Thailand for the charges and the court decisions against his some of the corruption practices occurred during his prime ministership. So what is happening in Thailand is, if you turn left, you see the military-led government. You turn right, you see the opposition, who is populist in nature and used to be very well versed in the principle of the might is right, the absolute majority in the parliament without any due regards to the minority voice or to respect the differences of opinion. So, but I could say that both sides in the parliament today are the, I think could be termed as they are illiberal Democrats. So in that sense, the Thai people in general would have to live with these two opposing political units who are illiberal and undemocratic. I think that is quite unfair for the Thai people at large who own the sovereignty of the country. They have the ownership of the Kingdom of Thailand, but somehow they seem to be under the yoke of illiberal democracy. So the point is, would the Thai people in general stand still and accept the fact, the reality, the fate of undemocratic way of life? Or they would like to stand up and do something about it to change Thailand from illiberal democracy into a more liberal democratic one, like any other civilized nations near and far, whether it's Taiwan, South Korea, Japan, Australia, New Zealand, Malaysia, and India, or even Nepal or Sri Lanka. So I think it's incumbent and it is the responsibility of the Thai people to stand up for freedom, for human rights, for a democratic governance. Okay? And in that sense, let me use the few more minutes to talk a bit of what I myself would like to do. I just want to recall that as of Tuesday, the 11th of June, three, four days ago, I went to the Democrat Party of Thailand and submitted my resignation, as I was against my party joining the coalition government led by General Prayut. I deemed that as deviating from the democratic principles and ideology of liberal democracy that the Democrat Party has been adhering to for more than 7 decades. So in that sense, I disagreed with the party leadership and I left the party. But having left the party as of 3 days ago, I intend to continue my political work to build up democracy and democratic participation of the country, to make democracy and to make the governing of the country to be covered by the principle of good governance and participatory politics. So on Tuesday last, on the 11th of June, besides announcing my resignation from the Democrat Party, I also have announced the launching of the Third Force People's Movement for Democracy. It is not a political party, it is a movement of ideas, of networking, of connecting to push Thailand back to a more democratic polity. And my ideas about democracy maybe covered three or four major elements. One, to be governed by morality, and the conduct of the affair of the state must be governed by the principle of good governance. Second one, the democracy for Thailand must be participatory, less government, more decentralization, more empowerment of the people of all walks of life. Then the third principle would be democracy that would ensure social justice, would ensure inclusiveness and equality for all, and access all the public services, utilities, housing, health, education, and so on, free if possible, or with a minimum charges and so on, to ensure the quality of life. Then the fourth principle is democracy that would honor the need for environmental preservation, a democracy that would enhance the local and community identities. So these maybe are the four basic principles that I would like to pursue under the so-called third force, in between the military involvement in politics and in between the involvement of dirty money in politics. So this is what I intend to do. And in that sense, I would like to invite all of you as friends of Thailand, as residents of Thailand, as visitors to Thailand, or even as students studying in Thailand, or my foreign friends, all of you, if you have any ideas to help me in thinking and about in trying to come out with a sort of a manifesto to push the furtherance of a democratic society for Thailand, all of you are welcome. You can email me, you can write to me, you can talk to friends and so on, and send some good tidings, some good ideas, so that we together could help to build up a true democratic society for Thailand in the near future as soon as possible. Thank you very much. See you next week. Sawasdee krab.